Welcome to another episode of I Wonder, Doctor.
Let's talk about anxiety and depression and the impact of uncomfortable thoughts and uncomfortable emotions on body biochemistry.
What do we do with the slippery slope? Because what I think I just heard you say is that if I have those emotions, it's hard on my physical body. And now I've also got the problems of my physical body to deal with.
And it is true. If you have uncomfortable emotions and thoughts, they trigger the fight or flight response. We're designed for that. That's okay. Yet not day in and day out for months and years. At a certain point, our bodies tire and can't keep up with the production of the hormones and neurotransmitters, at which point energy depletes, mood changes. The good news is there's a tremendous amount of information and tools and support out there to help us come back to and even grow into a better life. I wonder, Doctor, we care so much about this. We're going to share a lot of the information and tools that have helped those patients.
Turn the ship around.
Exactly.
Start to heal the body's ability to produce the hormones and the neurotransmitters, so thus we start to rise out of our anxiety and depression.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And sometimes when the anxiety and depression and depletion has been very significant, it's important to seek professional help that understands this and can help you restore, through medications even, brain chemistry, so that you can start functioning better in your day-to-day life. Yes, you will still have to do the emotional and mental and life work, but the medications, once again, can buy time. When it's really severe, you want to seek a psychiatrist. They're the ones that are most well-versed, especially with the extremes of mood and the medications that can assist you. Many family doctors and internists do a good job with the basics of mild and moderate situations. And then there's an army of counselors and groups out there that can assist you with the emotional and mental and life aspects of things. I highly encourage people to take that turn to where they make the phone call. They ask the friend, do you know anybody that can help me? They go to the group.
It seems like that first move is maybe sometimes the very hardest.
It is, and yet lift yourself up by your bootstraps. Make that call. It can be life-changing in a way that you'll celebrate so much, and you'll heal. You'll heal the internal body chemistry. You'll heal your body. You'll heal your life, your happiness, your ability to love and feel love.
So you've had patients succeed at this.
Absolutely.
Turn this tide.
Absolutely. And it's so dramatic. The restoration of their physical health. And, oh, yeah, you talk to someone who has had a major life change for the better. They love it.
The very first step might be the hardest step.
It might be the hardest one, and I can't tell you how much I encourage people to make it, because if you do, healing of the emotions and the mind and the life are possible.
Great. Thanks.